What's up, guys? Welcome back to another video. In this video, I wanted to show you guys how to get drones. I've never normally made a video on how to do that, but there is a way to get drones for free without spending real money. It's not as it's free, you still have to pay gold to get it, but it's not that you have to spend Fed credits to get drones. Also, don't mind my gold. I really don't have gold. So what you have to do is go to mall. And after you go there, you click sale pack, which is right here. Boom. This drone supplies box costs feds, but this one doesn't cost feds. It just costs gold. Now, do note, guys, you can buy only 5 boxes per day from here, which is 34k gold bars every day. So it is a little bit pricey for you free-to-play players out there. This is definitely going to be a little bit of a cost, and the chances to get these drone chips from this box is really low. Not like it's really high. If you check this one, which you need credits for, and the credits can be obtained by just spending Fed credits, this is also really not worth it, because even if you spend, it's like 0.001 chance to get the tier 3 medical drone, for example, or the blood lining. The blood lining is a little bit less rare than the tier 3 drone, but still, this stuff is pretty rare, and even if you spend Fed credits, this is really not worth spending on. If there's an event such as this one where you just, you know, spend credits on, do note, guys, you cannot get this night spirit or whatever with just, you know, these, with this currency. You have to spend Fed credits, and even if you spend Fed credits, you won't get this. So don't waste your time, you know, doing this. The only way to get drones is without actually spending money is buy from here the basic drone pack every day for 5 times and see if you get lucky. Learn all those 4, you will get some drone XP for drone compilation. But even if you do so, you will still be stuck at level 1 drone expertise. Like the compilation, you're not gonna reach level 2 unless you spend money. As you can see, I have medical chip unlocked. I had 5 crafts, so once I got the formula for the medical chip, I got 2 times craft for the combat chip, and I got 1 time craft for the blade hunter. I got pack chip 4 times. That also, I got lucky on the aerial ace event, and I got the self-destruct chip, and that's pretty much it. The rest are just locked because I have never gotten these, since these drones are heavily pay to win, or you need to spend a lot of money to get them. So I just unlocked the basic core drone chips. Now, as for modifying these drones, you really need this module etchants to upgrade your drone parts, and you need these photo etching pens to upgrade your chip. Yeah, I don't really mess with this, because this is just, you really need a lot of those etchants and pens to literally upgrade your chips. And I just leave this for the pay to wins to do this. Unless you have a lot of pens saved up and you have a chip that you really want to upgrade, you could go with the medical chip, because I think personally this is the most valuable chip that you could upgrade. And mine, this is what I have, decontamination. This is all I need, literally, just to heal my sickness when I'm sick. So I just pop my drone out, it heals me and gets my sickness bar, which is this gray bar right here. And yeah, that is extremely useful. Other than that, self-destruct chip or pack chip or combat chip, these are really useless ones. Well, the pack chip is good for, you know, storing stuff, which is this drone right here. This drone, I have a tier 4 collector's edition drone, which I bought for like 200k gold bars in Trade City. And yeah, that's it. You can store what? You can store 20 slots in this drone. Plus, you can store some stuff in your dock too. So, you know, that's like extra backpack slots here. And yes, guys, if you don't want to roll these drones, you can literally just buy a drone from the market and always look for a drone chip that has decontamination. Other than that, you don't really need anything else. As for the tier 4 pack chip, as you can see, they cost 300k in my server, up to 400, 500, and so on. So yeah, I would definitely buy the tier 4 chip, because you can store 20 slots again. As for the other drones, well, if you want to be toxic, you can buy the combat chip for Nancy. And pretty much all you need for Nancy is drone attack increases by 5%, this skill, and this skill right here, firing enhancement. Enhanced drone's airborne machine gun to increase its firepower, blah blah blah. So basically, it just makes your drone do the maximum damage possible to Nancy. Other than that, combat chips are pretty useless, especially in Farstar or Charlestown. I don't see people use them anymore. They might be good for early game, but for late game, they don't really do as much damage, since they added this HP enhanced and all of this, you know, like buffs for the drones that give you like crit immunity for your drone, they give you like more armor damage reduction to your drone, short range damage reduction. I mean, it does make drones better, but still, again, I don't really use drones anywhere except in ANSI. I just use my medical drones, so I don't really find this useful. Also, it's very expensive to use drones in combat. That's why I stay away from it. What I'm saying is, if you're a free-to-play player, that's even worse for you. Definitely, you don't want to use drones, because that will cost you. And drones don't really do that much of a difference in combat anyways. Now, a lot of people don't know how to fully reduce Dura when using drones. So what you can do, click this home icon, abilities, go to combat, and then scroll to the very, and this is the skill called Durable. Drone durability depletion rate reduced by 10%. So you have to max the skill, and then you basically lose 10% less Dura when your drone is being used. And the last skill, which I didn't mention, is the skill that increases your drone's Dura. So this skill right here, Durable, drone durability increases by 5%. So this skill is really important if you want your drone to last really long. Combined with this skill, 5%, and your combat skill, 10%, that's 15% less Dura lost, which will make your drones last longer. And it's worth looking at these stats before buying. So yeah, let's say there are drones that have decontamination, they have attack enhancement, and they have drone Dura, which is, that's really nice. But these are kind of expensive. Also, you could, you know, look into this skill right here. This is the stun skill that it just stuns other drones when they're near. But as you can see, it doesn't have Dura increase or doesn't have the decontamination skill. It has firing enhancement though, but that's not what we want. This drone, as you can see, decontamination, it has stun but doesn't have the durability. Revive is also a pretty good skill because, you know, if you die, the drone can revive you. And if you don't have a rainbow pendant, you can use this skill and just get your revive for free. But as you can see, this drone right here, it has revive, it has durability, but doesn't have decontamination. And this just has crap loads of skills but no decontamination, which sucks. And as you can see, we have found the best drone. It has decontamination, has durability increase, and has revive. This would be so far the best drone ever on the market. So, and it's not even that expensive. Don't look at the score, because people put the prices depending on the score, and people actually be like, oh my god, this drone has the best score and I'm gonna buy it. No, that's not how it works. Don't do that. Even if the drone has 3 skills or 4 skills, and it has, for example, decontamination, durability, and revive, that means it's the best drone. Well, obviously, if it has like firing enhancement, if it has stun, that's even better. This drone has decontamination and revive, but no durability. So yeah, that's what you actually want to prioritize when looking and buying drones, or when rolling drones. Like, you guys saw what I have on my drone, just decontamination, but if I wanted to, I could reroll this to get like revive, decontamination, and durability increase. But that is just, that's gonna take me ages, because it's really unlucky to roll stats on drones. As for drone parts, you can either craft your own basic parts. Remember, basic are just for healing, that's what I use. But if you want like a OP drone, you have to like get, you know, super energy cores combined with this premium engine, this premium framework, and I always like to put advanced navigator. But for that to work, you actually need good output power on your, you know, battery for the drone, because if you have too less output power and too much input power, and if the input power is higher than the output power, that means, you know, you can't use these drone parts together. Which is why I like to use basic drone parts for every of my drone, just like so, and I don't have to worry about anything. I just have this drone, which I always release in ANSI City, because, you know, if there's like a cancer team or something, if there's like a 1v5 and they're all using drones, literally, dude, I cannot do anything alone, so I have to get my drone out at least to do something and help me in combat. Other than that, these drones are just for healing, not for combat, so, you know, it's not really worth to get tier 4 parts for a medical drone, except the reason why I made this video is because people asked me how to get drones and how to get, you know, your drones to last longer. Based from the comments, I just decided to make this video, and hope this helps. Thanks for watching. I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace out.